Hi, we're with the PGG Wrightson technical team. I'm Jessica Dunbar and I'm the soil scientist for the South Island.
And I'm Stephanie Sloan, North Island soil scientist.
They let me out of the south because I was cold. And we are in
the Mighty Manawa 2. Today we are travelling around a few farms to address a couple of issues that we get as we move out of winter into spring.
So we're going to be covering quite a few different topics and we'll be travelling to several different cool locations. So let's go.
We're at JJ Farms in the Manawa 2 looking at doing a visual soil assessment. One of the reasons why we do this is because your soil's physical properties are essential to your pasture production or crop production success for the upcoming season. How we do that is one of the tools in your toolbox, you've got your trusty spade. So what we're going to do is we're going to dig a hole and have a look at four key properties. When looking at the physical properties of your soil, one of the first things we actually want to look at is your structure. So structure is really important for air movement, water movement, rooting, development through your soil, so what your fine root and coarse root material is like, as well as your root penetration down and further down the soil profile. The further down you can look at getting your root structure, the better availability you have of water and nutrients. When looking at your soil structure, you actually want to look at your aggregates. So what they actually look like. Are they blocky? Are they plain? Do they clump together? Or do you actually have a good distribution of them? So you've got firm, friable aggregate particles. The other thing that you want to look at is your soil porosity. So when we look at soil porosity, the ideal optimum is actually to have 50% of your soil as air. And again, this goes hand in hand with your soil structure, which actually looks at or influences your water movement, air movement throughout the soil. Soil with small aggregates have a larger number or tend to have a larger number of macropores, as opposed to large clods, which tend to have visually no apparent macropores. The third thing I want to talk about is soil mottling. So if we look at this soil, you can see that there is no really grey to red mottles, which is a good sign. It gives you a sort of a great visual indication of A, where your water level may sit to if you continue to dig further down your soil profile. The other thing that mottling does is it actually gives you a really good visual indication of how free draining your soils are or their ability for water and air movement to move through them. If you have poor mottling, as you can see in this soil type here, this results in orange and eventually grey mottles forming. So what happens is you can see them, they're often more prevalent further down the soil profile. They can lead to a reduction in nutrient uptake, which will limit your overall pasture yield. If you have any questions or queries, please feel free to contact your local technical field rep or call up the PGG Wrightson store.
And if this is the first Tech Tip video that you are watching, or you've watched several with us before, we hope you've enjoyed them and that you've learnt something, and make sure you go and check out the other videos, and we'll see you again soon.